Microtransactions in video games. Surely you've heard of them by now. Obviously this video is going to be about them, but I don't want to give the wrong impression from the start. I'm not against microtransactions in video games. I agree with Jim Sterling when he says microtransactions in video games can be a very good thing when implemented properly. Like most people who are talking about good examples of microtransactions, I'd like to point out Warframe. Nothing is locked away behind a paywall and everything substantial can be earned by playing Warframe, and not in a ridiculously long amount of time, either. Certain cosmetics are locked behind microtransactions in Warframe, sure, but that is mostly the fan-made ones, not the ones that come with the game. I've earned 2 or 3 different helmets for my Warframes as well as 5 different Warframes through gameplay and Prime Warframe I got just for signing up for a free trial of Twitch Prime. An example of terrible microtransactions would obviously be Star Wars Battlefront 2 when it first came out. There are many other examples of terrible microtransactions in AAA games, but I think most people agree that those were the most insulting and despicable. This video isn't really about good or bad implementations of microtransactions in video games, though. It's mostly about being forced to turn our cash or digital money into fake currencies within these games. I don't like it and I don't understand why it's legal. Why are people okay with that? It seems inherently suspicious to me. With or without them, companies are deciding for us what the items being sold as microtransaction are worth, right? So why do they need us to convert our real money into a fake form of money that can't be spent on anything other than in-game purchases? Again, with or without the fake currencies, companies can still get us to give them certain amounts of money for use only at their businesses. Gift cards, Steam wallet money, PlayStation account money, etc. all exist and don't seem to bother people that much. Perhaps it's because you know the value of the money you put on the gift card, but I personally think it's because you know you can still spend your real cash at those places. You can put money on a gift card to these stores or get a gift card to these stores and use it like a discount on future purchases from that business. That's not possible with these fake currency microtransactions. From a business standpoint, it makes some sense. You can force or trick people into spending more than they need because your fake currency can only be bought in set chunks of whatever the currency is, but the items purchased with that fake currency usually don't add up to the amounts they can be bought in. This to me is more egregious than being allowed to stockpile real-world cash in an account that can only be spent on in-game purchases. For example, I can dump $100 into my Steam wallet. That money can only be used on Steam, sure. But I can still choose to spend my real-world cash in specific amounts on specific things I want. I don't have to first load money onto my Steam wallet and then spend it from the Steam wallet. That wouldn't make sense and would come off as an anti-consumer business practice, because it is. Forcing people to buy set amounts of your fake currency instead of just letting them fork over the same amount in real-world cash or digital money, is an anti-consumer practice. Imagine if other businesses tried to pull those shenanigans. No more showing up at the grocery store to spend your money. Now you have to buy grocery points. You can buy X number of points for X number of dollars and everything on the shelves is listed in terms of how many points it is. Can you imagine that madness? Several companies that aren't in the gaming industry allow you to earn points by shopping there and spend those points instead of real money, but that's not nearly the same as making your entire inventory available for purchase only with points instead of actual money. What I mainly don't understand is why it's legal still. It doesn't make sense to me that a company would be allowed to force me to buy points with real money if I'm trying to buy stuff from them. Points I can only buy in increments the company decides and have a value the company doesn't have to disclose. Again, I refer to my grocery store analogy. And it comes down to how pointless it is. It still has to be converted to a real-world currency to be purchased. Why not just use the real-world currency? You can still adjust the prices as you wish. Why do you need to get algebra involved? You can offer more money to people who spend more at once. Ever heard of the concept of buying a $50 gift card to a place for $25? The grocery store chain Kroger offers double reward points on gift purchases and sometimes offer 4 times the normal amount of points. The same concept applies to games. How do I know this? That would be the most consumer-friendly version of this system that I've seen so far. Warframes. A part of the pool of daily rewards you can earn when logging into the game each day is discounts on the fake currency used to purchase things in the game. They've offered 20 to 50% discounts on purchases made of their platinum, the fake currency. What this shows me is that they know they can afford to fluctuate the prices of their microtransactions given the fact that all the products are digital. Nothing has to be produced for the purchase. The product is available for an infinite amount of use simply by existing. That's the beauty of game and digital products and purchases. Their lower production cost allows them to fluctuate their prices more than any physically produced product currently can. So once again I have to wonder, why do they need the fake currencies? Nothing against Warframe, I obviously love the game and support the developers. I'm also not trying to insinuate that Warframe is the only game with fake currencies that does fake currencies in a tolerable way. I still don't like the idea of having to buy platinum to buy things in game instead of being able to just give them a dollar or two when I want to unlock something for money or to get something in exchange for supporting a free-to-play game. I just dislike it less than I dislike most implementations of fake currencies in games. Far less, actually. I should also mention that there is a trading bazaar and healthy trading community and it's possible to earn Warframes Platinum without spending money just by playing the game and selling Warframes or weapons or mods for the Platinum. Other players are often willing to purchase them. There's an in-game economy of the Platinum and I think it's partly thanks to the steep discounts on it offered as login rewards, and partly because new players get free Platinum just for joining. Not to mention the Prime Access program that offers the newest Prime Warframe and weapons plus some free platinum with it. Still, I can't help but wonder why not just allow players to put cash on their accounts instead of keeping track of how much fake currency they have. It's essentially the same thing, but perfectly clear about how much you have and allows you to directly spend cash on in-game items you want without conversion rates involved. With that, I'm going to end this video. I'd like to know what all of you think. Do you agree? Does what I said make any sense? Do I sound stupid and crazy? Any questions or comments you have would be greatly appreciated. And stay safe till next time. Error. Error. Error.